Welcome to the Agile community and our technical tips and tricks videos. My name is Sebastian Perisa, Director of Community and Senior Engineer. Today I will guide you through the process of how to register a device manually. So why do you want to register a device manually if you can use the automatic registration process, which is usually used by putting out a DHCP option or DNS alias? The first reason, which is quite simple, you might not have a DHCP option or not the ability to install an option on your DHCP scopes, or you don't have a DNS by hand. Second thing is you might have a UMS hosted by a service provider who is not able to configure that feature because of less knowledge or just because he is not allowed to do so. Sometimes it's also because you just don't want to wait for a reboot if the device needs a configuration right now, or if you want to move the device from a test to a prod system. What I'm always seeing too is that a feed service is installing the devices and you cannot rely on a DHCP scope because you have different floors and all floors are connecting through a specific DHCP but not on a floor level. Last but not least, the ICG is in use, so you will use the ICG registration process and not the automatic registration done by the automatic registration itself.
Like on every tutorial, we are starting with a Universal Management Suite, also known as UMS. So I know that I have a virtual machine started up for today, which is not registered by UMS at the moment. So I will scan inside of my local network if my device is reachable. If I don't want to use the local network of the UMS itself, I can specify a range where I want to search for devices. Just be aware that we have a couple of ports that you need to be opened to get the scan successful and to get the registration process done. We will have a separate session on how to debug that specific behavior. So let's start with the scan process from the UMS side, searching for devices inside of my network. And just be aware that it will show every device that is reachable in this network and is an Agile operating system. So even if you have devices that are already registered, they will be shown here. In my case, I'm checking if a device is a certificate stored no. That means that it is not registered to another UMS. And check the include checkbox to include that endpoint into my UMS. Just because I know where I want that the device will be registered to, I will choose a specific folder that I created for my demo lab. So now the device is getting enrolled and a certificate file called server.cat is exchanged between the UMS and the endpoint to ensure that the device cannot be managed by another UMS server. So that's already the way to register a device from the UMS to the endpoint. Now just to do the other way around, so from the endpoint to the UMS, I will reset the device to factory defaults and do the test again in a couple of seconds. Let's switch back to the device. So now with our first run wizard, which I will cancel, and I will register the device from a feed service point of view. So let's imagine you are not delivering the devices by yourself, but from a feed service perspective, and you are not able to change the DHCP or DNS options on the customer network. You can go to System, UMS Registration, enter the DNS name or the IP address of the UMS server you want to reach, enter a username and a password, and then you have a really cool feature which is not that always known. You can now check on directory select. And now you see all the folders inside of UMS, so you can from the beginning on decide where the device will be registered, but also in which directory the device will be moved. So in my case, I would use my folder again, en_de, check OK, and register. Successfully registered. Let's check if that's true. Let me refresh my UMS console. And yes, my device is showing up. So that's exactly what I wanted to do. So let's imagine the feed service is moving a device from one building to another, and you have a specific follow structure for that building. You can do that from the endpoint too without having to script something using yet or the NT. So let's come back to the command line interface. Like explained, you can also create a script with YAT or Zenity to make a registering process automatically or by hand, or if you want to do that from the feed service itself without using the IGL tool. So let's go to the command line. So first of all, I created a local terminal session, which is covered by another tutorial. And now I'm using a function called rmdbregister. So let me check which syntax we need. So we need rmdb register, then S for server. In my case, that's my UMS IP address. A port, which should be 30001 if not configured differently. A username. A password. And a directory if we need it. Okay, now. So now the last step. I want to register a device manually by using the ICG agent setup. If you want to do that after the first one with that, so going into the start menu to system ICG agent setup, entering the UL you want to reach, entering if needed a structure tag, or in my case just the multiple time password. Waiting for the ICG connection to be ready, click on finish, and your configuration should be done. That looks good. Thank you for joining our technical video session. All links mentioned in this session are available in the show notes section of this video. You will find more technical content and other videos on agilecommunity.com and agileacademy.learn.agile.com.